Today, I want to show you the easiest and the fastest way to remove background noise in Premiere Pro. Besides just background noise, you can also have reverb, hum, and rumble in your audio clip. If you haven't yet subscribed, hit that subscribe button and turn on notifications so you don't miss any of my tutorials. So we're going to start off in the Essential Sound panel. If you don't see the Essential Sound panel, you can come up to Window and click right here where it says Essential Sound, or you can come up here to the top and click on this icon, and this will show you all the workspaces, and you can click on Audio. Essential Sound is right here, and first I'm going to let you hear how this audio sounds. I'm using the onboard microphone on my camera just so you can see it's possible to get good audio from a lower quality microphone. So here goes. This is an audio test with the onboard microphone. Testing 1, 2, 3, 4. Air conditioning is on, and this room has a lot of echo. First thing I'm going to do is I'm going to select my audio track and come up here to where it says dialogue. I'm going to tag this as a dialogue, and it might be easier to work on your clip if you just choose an area and loop through it.
With the onboard microphone, testing 1, 2, 3, 4. Air conditioning is on.
I'm going to set an in point right here on the clip. And I set an out point and hit O. And now up here, right under the program monitor, you should see an icon for loop playback. And if you don't, click on this plus right here, the button editor. And right here is the loop playback. Drag that down to the bottom right here and say OK. And click on that. And now you can press your space bar and it should loop through your in and out points.
Testing 1, 2, 3, 4. Air conditioning is on.
Now over here in your Essential Sound panel, it should say repair. Click on that. You should see almost everything you need to reduce noise in your audio. That's what makes the Essential Sound panel so good. It has most of the tools you need to clean up your audio. I'm going to start off by adjusting the reduced noise. I'm going to click on that and adjust it and listen to the audio. Keep in mind though, as you make these adjustments, it could affect the actual audio quality of the voice. So we have to be careful and find a balance.
Testing 1, 2, 3, 4. Air conditioning is on. Testing 1, 2, 3, 4. Air conditioning is on. Testing 1, 2.
So next I'm going to try reverb. There's a lot of reverb in this room. So let's try that.
Is on. Testing 1, 2, 3, 4. Air conditioning is on. Testing 1, 2, 3, 4. Air conditioning is on. Testing 1, 2, 3, 4. Air conditioning.
So now you have the option of maybe trying reduce rumble or dehum and see how that affects the audio or if it makes it a little bit better. So it's just a process to go through to see if you can reduce the most noise, but still maintain as much of the audio quality.
Testing 1, 2, 3, 4. Air conditioning is on. Testing 1, 2, 3, 4. Air conditioning is on.
Try dehum.
Testing 1, 2, 3, 4. Air conditioning is on. Testing 1, 2, 3, 4. Air conditioning is on. Testing 1, 2, 3, 4. Air conditioning is
on. So reduce rumble may have helped a little bit, but definitely not dehum. So now let's try and bring back the voice, see if we can get that quality a little bit better, because we know from all the adjustments we've made so far that the quality of the voice has gone down a little bit. So let's try EQ. There's a preset we can try. You can try all these, but I think podcast voice would sound good. Let's see how that sounds.
Is on. Testing 1, 2, 3, 4. Air conditioning is on. Testing 1, 2, 3, 4. Air conditioning is on. Testing 1, 2, 3, 4. Air conditioning is on. Testing 1, 2, 3.
And one more thing we can do is we can click on enhance speech and we'll click on low tone. So if you have a clip that has gotten too many highs coming in because of all the adjustments you've made, you can click on enhance speech and low tone.
Before, air conditioning is on. Testing 1, 2, 3, 4. Air conditioning is on.
And so that helped. We have some of our low tones coming back in. One thing about using the Essential Sound panel is when you make adjustments like this, it applies to a clip, not the whole track. So in this case here, I have just one clip, but if you had multiple clips on the track, you would have to do something like this. First, you need to save your settings as a preset. So we'll come up here to the top and click here, and we'll call this demo preset and say okay. So now in this first clip, I have the demo preset selected, and you can see up here in the effects controls, here it is, all my effects, denoise, reverb. But if I click over to this other clip, nothing is applied. So that's what I mean. If you had multiple clips and you made all your adjustments in the Essential Sound panel, it's only going to apply to that clip, not to the other clips on the timeline. So Since we saved it as a preset, just select that clip, come up here to your preset in the Essential Sound panel. Here's Demo Preset. Now if you look at the effects controls, here are my reverb and denoise. I can do that to my next clip here. Same thing, select my demo preset, and it is applied there too. And if you need to change any of these settings on an individual clip, like say reverb, you can come up here in the effects control panel. You can click on edit, and here you have a chance. You can change the amount, and it's going to change the reverb just on that clip. You can go back to each of the clips and go to the effects control and click on edit and bring up a dialog like this to change values. So let's play it all back. This is how it all sounds.
This is an audio test with the onboard microphone. This is an audio test with the onboard microphone.
If you want more tutorials just like this, click on one of the videos on the screen now. If you haven't already, like, share, and subscribe. And remember, it's never too late to learn. Thanks for watching.